Hi guys, welcome to the general knowledge series. In this series, basically I'm going to be posting a couple of videos along with the analysis, which will include GK and the current affairs, sometimes case studies also. So the right audience for this kind of video series is an MBA aspirant, first of all. If you are somebody who is preparing for all the MBA exams from CAT till CET, you can get a lot of benefits from this. Then comes GK based MBA entrance exams. If you are preparing for MBA exams like IFT, TIS, CMAT, SNAP, wherein you know GK comes, then these kind of videos will help you a lot. And if you're somebody who is an MBA student, if you're studying in a B school and you know preparing for your interviews and you know want to build up your knowledge about the market, about the case studies, about the analysis from all the different verticals, definitely these kind of series will help you. Also, if you're preparing for bank exams like bank PO, SSC, IBPS exams, for the GK content, this is going to help you a lot. And if you're somebody who is going to appear for GDs or personal interview for your job, for your any exam or for college, this is gonna give you a good benefit. Alright, so let's get started and see what's the topic for the day. So today's topic is, what's wrong with Yes Bank? In this video, I'm going to talk about the analysis on falling share price of Yes Bank and what are the reasons that are driving the fall in the price of the Yes Bank. Now, before we move ahead, let's understand the history of Yes Bank. It's a very good bank. It has been the strongest bank in the country. Like one of the strongest bank, by the way. One of the reputed bank in the country, by the way. Now, couple of days back, like it's September 21st, 22nd, 2018, the share price started tumbling, by the way, okay? And there are a lot of negative thoughts about the bank in the market. So let's understand a little bit of analysis before we get to the actual reason. Okay, so here it is. So what do you have? So if you look at the share price of Yes Bank back in 5 years, so I have this analysis for like 5 years. So if you look at here, this is the 5 year analysis. Now look at the price. The share price of the company was 60.92 INR. That was good. Now if you look at the growth of Yes Bank, if I like from 2018, if you go 5 years back, that's around about 2013, 2014. I think the bank has done a fantastic job. If you ignore 2018, like if you ignore September month, like all these 23, 24 days of September month in 18, and if you look at the share price till August 30th or 31st, I think there is a sharp increase as far as the share price is concerned. So if you're somebody who has invested couple of grands in Yes Bank like 5 years back, you must have made really good money. So if you look at 5 years chart of Yes Bank, things look fantastic. Now let's have a look at the another chart. If you look at the another chart wherein things are not that glorious, so you need to understand, you know, what went wrong actually. So let's move ahead. Let's see. Okay, so this is one of the chart wherein what you can see is the share price falling down. Now this shows you a little different picture altogether, isn't it? It's only for 1 year. Yes, it's only for 1 year. Now if you look at the 1 year analysis out here, the picture is not that great. So I'm talking about 1 year means September 17 till September 18. Now, if you look at the share price was 359 a year back, and you can see the share price here going below 250. Okay, now that's a really bad decrease as far as the share price is concerned. Now, this is where the actual problem started. From last year, the share price starting getting on a toss, basically. So you see, in a year's time, your share price has gone down by more than 100 bucks, which is not a good sign for a company altogether. Now let's understand, what's the share price today itself? Okay, so today's share price, if you check, 226.15 rupees. Now that's a really nightmare. Now a lot of you will not be happy, right, that why it happened. So if you look at this scenario, right, 235 was the price, today you are sitting around about 226.15. Really, really bad, okay? So this is the data which is on September 24th, 2018, the share price is around about 1:30 PM in the afternoon. So if you look at, the share price has gone down drastically. So 5 years earlier, you had a share price going exactly up. Now you have scenario wherein your share price is tumbling down, right? Now, if you look at the opening price today was 236 and the lowest is 215. Oh, actually it went down and then it went up. So that's the lowest on 24th September 2018. Now you have understood that there is something miserably wrong as far as Yes Bank is concerned, because from last 4 minutes, whatever I'm saying, I'm only telling you is that, okay, look at the peak of the bank. Look at all those glorious days, all those, you know, India growth story. And where is the bank as of now? Now, why it is happening with this bank? What's the major problem that in a day your share gets on a toss? Look at this V-shape out here. Look at this V-shape out here. Look at where your share comes in a day's time, right? Now, understand you are at this position. Okay, you are at this position. You are a shareholder. You have no clue that this is gonna go up. You are about to get a heart attack. When your price goes directly down, it's a steep fall in the price. Understand how scary this is, right? And then the price comes up, but again it goes down out here. And now the price is kind of stabbing on 224 rupees till 227, 28 bucks. Okay, now let's move ahead and understand why there are so many problems as far as the Yes Bank is concerned. Now the bank which have been doing very well from last 5 years, all of a sudden everything gets wrong with this bank. Okay, now the problem with this bank is NPAs. Now the NPA is the major problem. What is NPA? NPA is called as, let me write it down for you guys here. NPA is basically called as non-performing assets. Now what do you mean by non-performing assets? Non-performing assets, now NPA has a long story, so when you talk about non-performing assets, I'm not really going to get into the depth of it, but let's understand what do you mean by non-performing assets, sorry for that. Now, let me give an example. Okay, so, say, the problem is, say, there is somebody, say, Mr. A is there, okay, and, you know, say, Mr. A has lent, say, a couple of bucks to, say, Mr. B, okay, so he lent, say, 1,000 rupees to Mr. B. And Mr. B promises to return that to Mr. A in a month's time. Okay. Now, Mr. A, after a month, is expecting 1,000 rupees to be taken back from Mr. B. And then Mr. B comes on one fine morning and say that, you know what, there is a problem in my family and I will not be able to pay you back. So, Mr. A, who was expecting 1,000 rupees, now will be getting 0 rupees from Mr. B. So, what happened? Basically, he has a loss. It's a bad debt. So, in the same case, say there is a bank, okay? So, there is a bank. It's a pretty good bank. So, what happens is that bank lends some amount of money to some people in the country, right? So, this is the bank out here, okay? Here is a bank, any bank. Say, this is the Yes Bank, by the way. So, bank lent money to a couple of guys in the market, right? Now, they lend, say, around about, say, let's take 1,000 rupees to people in the market. Now, if you look at when a bank lends money to people, when there is a lending that happens, right, that basically gets added to the asset of a bank. If you look at the balance sheet of any bank, whenever a bank lends some money, that gets into the assets. Why? Because the money which has given to public by the bank is an asset because that earns money for a bank. Now, what kind of money it earns? It earns interest for a bank. And that's the main earning for any bank in the world. So funder remains the same. Now what happens is people say that, okay, we will pay you this money in the form of equated monthly installments. So whatever 1,000 rupees that company has given to the market or bank has given to the market, bank can expect that money to come in some tranches, like maybe say 20 rupees every month from all the people. Now what happens all of a sudden is that for first 3 months or for first 4 months, people pay every EMI very well, diligently. But what happens after 4 or 5 months? People stop paying the money. Reason can be anything. There are n number of reasons for people not to pay back money to the bank. Okay, but what happens? The company was expecting, okay, 1,000 bucks have gone to the market. So company says, you know what, on an average, every month I'm expecting 100 rupees to come back to me. But for the fact people are not paying, the bank is getting only 20 rupees. So what is the rest of the 80 rupees? That is called as NPA, non-performing asset. Means, according to RBI Act 1934, if any EMI or any installment that doesn't come to you in 90 days, that will be called as non-performing asset. We will not get into the depth of non-performing asset. Just understand. So non-performing asset is any amount that people are not paying back to the bank for consecutive 90 days, and that's a problem for the bank because, as I said, bank has given money to the people, and if people do not give that money back to the bank, then how bank gonna make money? And if bank do not get the money back, how bank will lend more money and how bank will make money? Also, people who have deposited money with the bank, what will happen if they want their deposit back? So if the people are not paying money to the bank, there is a huge problem. So this is the main problem with Yes Bank. The problem is people are not paying back the money, or NPAs. I'll be creating another video on NPS, by the way. But this is a major problem. Now, every bank has to go through this, okay? This is something not new. Every bank has to go through this. But the problem is that when you hide this from central bank, yes, that's the major problem. So when you hide this information, and hiding this information from central bank is actually bad. It's really bad. Now let's see what Yes Bank literally did in a couple of years' time. Rather, they shouldn't have ever done this. The problem is that they actually went for this. Let's understand this. Okay, now here is the chart. I want you to guys have a quick look at. So the Yes Bank started hiding these numbers right from 2016, end of the financial year. Now, what is the data? Now, let me give you a data basically, or if we just kind of do the analysis. So, actually, Yes Bank reported their non-performing asset only 2%. Now, listen to me very carefully. So, they said that, you know what, our non-performing assets are only 2%, okay? But if you look at what they actually reported, they reported back in 2017 beginning, they reported non-performing asset as 748.98 crores. Okay, okay. Now let me take an example. Okay, so say there is A. Okay, his father is C. So A says that, you know what, Dad, I did a good job in my exam. On 100, I got say 82 marks in a paper, maybe whatever paper, social science. And Dad gets very happy. Dad says that, you know, wow, that's wonderful. Good, keep that report card with you. Now, Dad wants to see that report card by himself. So he asks for that report card. And what exactly happened was, you actually scored 128 marks. So you basically lied to your father. Means Yes Bank lied to the central bank of the country, which is the parent bank, that's RBI. Now what happened was, when Yes Bank said, okay, 2% is the NPA, which is 748.98 crores, RBI did buy it. But when RBI did its own due diligence, when it did its own calculations, and when it digged into the financials of Yes Bank, the actual NPA, which was sitting on SBI's balance sheet or financial, was rupees 4,925.68 crores. That's humongous. So think about it, how much you lied to the bank. He lied to RBI, and you underperformed and you undershowed your non-performing assets by 557%. Now this is huge, guys. Okay, you cannot do this. Now as a bank, when you are sitting on people money, you cannot lie to RBI, which is the parent bank of the company. So this is what happened at the first go. But did this stop? No, this did not stop. So as I said, caught again. So this was not the first time that happened. It happened again and again. So RBI started catching Yes Bank again and again and again and again. So there is something called as divergence. So if you look at the gross NPA showed by Yes Bank, this is here, at what came by from RBI. So RBI said, you know what, you told me this is your NPA, but this is not. This is your NPA actually. So if you look at the divergence, I will not take a divergence. I'll put it as a variance. So the variance, what Yes Bank showed to the bank, and what RBI got to know, so the difference, the variance here is this much. So this is what the variance is. So you can look at these figures, and these are humongous. This is not a joke, by the way, right? And that's where RBI started getting mad at Yes Bank. Now, what happened later on? So RBI said, you know what? You better tell us what exactly is your problem and what exactly is your NPAs. And then Yes Bank came up with the actual figure. And guys, look at this figure, okay? Problem solved? No, it's not. If you look at this, is the problem. What they actually, so if you look at this number out here, this whole thing is what previously unacknowledged NPA by Yes Bank. So they came up with saying that, you know what, we lied to you, we are coming back, and okay, this is what it is. This is what the shit is all about. And that's what Yes Bank did. But was it really satisfying as far as the RBI is concerned back in September 30, 2017? No, it wasn't. And that's where RBI decided to pull the plug. Now, when I say to pull the plug, RBI really got mad at this policy or the management of Yes Bank. And that's where they said that, you know what? What are we going to do is basically, we are saying that the main guy, the CEO, which is Rana Kapoor, then they say that, you know what? He should be leaving the bank now, because There are three major problems that RBI sees as far as Yes Bank is concerned. Three major problems are, okay, so the weak compliance culture in Yes Bank, weak governance in Yes Bank, and weak or rather wrong asset qualification. So RBI says that Yes Bank from last one and a half year has been failing continuously on these three major problems or these three major things. RBI saying that Yes Bank is not taking into consideration, and RBI has a lot of problem with that. So these are the three main problems. So if you go for GD, PI, or wherever, you can put these 3 points across the table. So these are the main problems as far as your Yes Bank is concerned. And definitely, why Rana Kapoor is in trouble now? Because he is the main guy who's running the bank from 2004. So he co-founded Yes Bank back in 2004. From then, he is leading the bank, and he's been doing it fantastically, very well. But now, for the fact, if your house is on a fire, who is to be blamed for it? Is the karta of your house, which is the father, which is Rana Kapoor, right? So Rana Kapoor is under surveillance of RBI, and RBI is not happy with the leadership altogether. And that's the reason RBI said that, you know, he should be actually leaving the bank. So the 3 year tenure of Rana Kapoor was not agreed by the RBI, and RBI said that, you know, he has to leave the company by January 2019. And that's what spread it. That's what people could not buy it. And that's the reason there has been a lot of negative concerns about Yes Bank, that okay, a guy who has been able to build up the bank from scratch is now going to leave. So what's going to happen to the loans? How the bank is going to make money? What's going to happen to the NPAs? How they will be recovered? So many problems are around the table now. And again, there is another problem as far as your Yes Bank is concerned. The major problem which analysts or MBA students or MBA aspirants do not take into consideration, or you should be looking at this, is called as shareholding pattern of a company. A lot of people, even MBA finance guys, they kind of, you know, screw at this. They don't understand. It's very important that you should be looking at shareholding pattern of a company. Now, why RBI is running after his life is because he is a promoter, okay? And if you look at a promoter stake in a company, is round about 20%. So yes, this is what Rana Kapoor and his family, the promoter and undivided Hindu family, is actually holding. So when you hold 20% in your company, you can see, not necessary that you will do, but that's how people, or that's how the apex bank of the country might take it as, you know what, for the fact you have a huge stake in your company, you might do a lot of manipulations, you might do certain wrong things to get the benefit from those things. You're getting my point? So you are the owner, you have 20% stake in the company, you lied to us, you kind of, you know, underrated your NPAs, you kind of undershown them to us. Because you are the owner, you have 20% stake, so you do worry about your money and your share price. And that may be the reason that the RBI or people or the analyst is saying that maybe there are certain bad things happening inside the company because of the stake of the promoter. But again, like, every coin has two sides, in the head and the tail, by the way. If you look at the 43% comes from FII. So FII is just controlling this bank, to be very honest. But again, this can be one of the reasons. If you're an MBA student doing finance, you must check into this data. It's important. So this is the overall story of your Yes Bank, the NPA problem, the bad sentiments in the market, the promoter stake in the market. And that's the reason, if you look at what is the call from the broker side. So if you look at the top-notch companies, they've said that sell the stock. Edelweiss said buy, but again, you know, this is what the call is in the market as far as your Yes Bank is concerned. So now I'm very sure you are cleared about why Yes Bank shares are falling. There is not only one particular reason. There is an operation reason. There is a corporate governance reason. There is a management reason also, right? Guys, I hope you like this video. This will do some value addition to you. And I'm going to come up with a lot of videos like this. So do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for your time, guys. Thanks a lot.